I hope you're going to find interest and enjoy what you actually see today. Tess, Ms. Walker's going to give a talk through the rationale of why this room exists and why we're here. What you're going to see today really is it's sort of symbolic, really. It's the start of our journey. So it's the launch of our journey of us moving into a new school and starting to think about how we're going to change the way that we're going to teach. And I want you to bear that in mind when you see what we put on here today. We could have gone for sort of high definition film and sort of spectacular stuff, but what is important to us is that we start to engage with the technology.
Many of you here come from an educational background or were educated at least maybe 30 years plus ago, and you will remember very clearly blackboards, and then the innovation of whiteboards, and then the further innovation of interactive whiteboards. And we have to ask the question, where next? Because we know there will be a next. We know that because the only constant is change, we will be moving. Here's a quote, which I was looking this morning for some quotes on change. And this one was an unknown author. It's change, continuing change, inevitable change, that is the dominant factor in society today. Decisions we make must be based not on what the world is like, but on what the world will be like. But we do know that if you can possibly merge the two and you can get something which is not just entertaining but also educational, you're on to a winner. Right, I want to also think about the when very quickly. The when for us, when should we have all this new technology? When should we be engaging children the way we feel they need to be engaged? We want to change the habits that have been going on in the United Kingdom for a long time. The banks will get the technology long before education. Industry will get the technology long before education. That's wrong, ladies and gentlemen. That needs to be changed around. We should be getting the technology first because our young people need it. And that's the only good reason for making sure that we get that technology in place as quickly as possible. And we've got something that the banks haven't got. They've got more money than us. We've got something they have got. It comes in the shape of this young man and the other digital leaders that you're going to meet shortly. Brilliant young brains, because they're the best ones at creating the change needed to develop the new technology. They're exactly what we need. They're our best resource. And are you ready to cut the ribbon?
Whenever you are, miss.
Great, thank you.
Do you want to press the button, miss?
Yeah.
Thank you. really cute.
Just been in for the presentation, and you began by quoting Asimov and constant change. It's an amazing leap the school has made in 4 years.
Yes, it is. But the whole point of that presentation really was that we're not satisfied. We can see into the future to some extent. We know where we want to be, we know how things want to look. And it's really important for us that we keep moving. We made big change when we stopped becoming a community school, became an academy. We made a change to the build. Now we've got time for another massive quantum leap. And that is because we're having a new build. It gives us a chance to say, right, okay, we've done a lot in 4 years, but now we're ready to make another massive trajectory in the right direction. It's not just constant change, it's accepting that change is the only constant, but making it work for us and making it work fast enough.
Even the World War I presentation there, to somebody of a certain age, you know, Princep assassinates the Archduke, and then all the countries get involved and read next 5 pages, 10 pages. This is another world of presenting a subject like history, yes. Isn't it?
What it allows, really, is for children who... We remember our history teachers, no doubt, Michael. They used to tell us about World War I, and it's only as you become more adult and you get an understanding of the true emotions and the devastation that occurred, does it really actually start touching you. Perhaps we can bring that feeling on earlier by allowing children to be immersed in the battlefields, by allowing them to actually get a feeling for what it was like to be standing next to someone. It's all part of the learning process, to be able to, I suppose, empathise better.
A digression slightly. Last Monday, a week ago, you were at the council offices of the local,
yes,
corporation. Pleased with what? The rubber stamping?
Well, I think you can tell by my face, it's more than pleased. What it means to this community, it's hard to put into words. We've been wanting this for such a long time. This building is fine, we've made it look as pretty as it can be, but in truthfulness, it's not right for a 21st century education. What we need now is to really move on and to make sure that we can provide people with the environment where that kind of technology can be commonplace, where a child can be immersed in different environments and help accelerate that learning process.
Thank you very much.